Hello everyone, welcome back. This is the sixth lecture on the topic impact of jet on curved vanes. In the previous lectures we have seen if a jet is striking a curved vane at its center, what is the impact of the jet, work done and what is the efficiency of the jet. When the jet strikes the vane at its center that is normal to the vane, some amount of shock or whirl is generated at the inlet which results in energy loss. This can be reduced if the jet enters the vane smoothly or if the jet enters the vane tangentially. That is what we are going to see in this lecture. At the end of this lecture, you will be able to apply impulse momentum principle to analyze the work done by a jet on a stationary curved vane enters the vane tangentially. Then we will see the case if the vane with a velocity u, but in this case u and v, where v is the velocity of the jet, u and v are not in the same direction. To analyze this case we need to draw the velocity triangle, so we will be explaining how to draw the triangle in this lecture. Accordingly, this lecture is organized in such a way that during the first part of the lecture, we will discuss the application of impulse momentum principle to calculate the impact of jet on a stationary curved vane. Jet enters the vane tangentially. And in the second part of the lecture, we will discuss in detail how to draw the velocity triangles for the case of a moving curved vane. In the previous lectures, we have seen the case of a curved vane with a jet striking the vane at its center and the vane is moving with a velocity u along the same direction as that of the jet velocity v. In that case, we have seen the expression for the impact of jet as fx equal to rho a into v minus u whole square into 1 plus cos theta, where v minus u is the relative velocity with which the jet is striking the vane. In this case, since v and u are in the same direction, the relative velocity is the difference between v and u, that is v minus u. And if there are a series of curved vanes mounted on a wheel and if the jet strikes the vane at its center, then the force is given by rho a v into v minus u into 1 plus cos theta. So in this case, there is no mass loss because there is always a curved vane at front of the jet at this position and always the mass striking the vane is rho av. But the velocity with which this jet is striking the vane is the relative velocity, which is again v minus u in this case. So in both these cases, the impact of jet is expressed as a function of the relative velocity with which the jet is striking the vane. But in both these cases, the vane velocity and the jet velocities are in the same direction. Therefore, the relative velocity is obtained in a simple way, that is v minus u. Next, we are going to see the case if u and v are not in the same direction. Consider the case of this curved vane. Assume this vane to be smooth and frictionless, and you can see in this diagram this is a fixed vane. That means it is not allowed to move in the horizontal direction or along the vertical direction or along the x direction or in the y direction. X and y directions are marked here. And this vane is asymmetrical about the x axis, which means that you can see here, if this is the x axis, the inlet of the vane makes an angle theta with respect to the x axis, whereas the outlet is inclined at an angle phi to the x axis. That means the vane is not symmetrical about the x axis. Inlet vane angle is theta, outlet vane angle is phi. The jet is entering the vane tangentially, which means that this is the direction of velocity of the incoming jet, and it glides through the vane and comes out in this direction. Again, it leaves the vane tangentially without any shock at the inlet. It enters the vane without any shock and it leaves the vane without any shock in this space, which means that velocity of the jet is tangential to the vane at the inlet and velocity of the jet is tangential to the vane at the outlet, which means that the incoming velocity, which was initially in this direction, and it changes to this direction after impinging on the vein, which means that the jet got deflected through an angle 180 minus theta plus phi. So 180 minus theta plus phi is the deflection angle, and vein angle is theta at the inlet and phi at the outlet. In this case also, you can apply the impulse momentum principle to calculate the impact of this jet. So this incoming velocity v, which is inclined at an angle theta to the x-axis, can be resolved into components, that is v cos theta along the positive x direction and v sin theta along the positive y direction. Similarly, this outgoing velocity v also can be resolved into components along the x and y direction. So the component will be v cos phi, because the vein angle at the outlet is phi. So v cos phi, and it is along the negative x direction, and v sin phi along the positive y direction. As we have seen in the earlier cases, if the vein is assumed to be smooth and frictionless, we assume that the magnitude of the velocity remains unchanged as the jet flows through the vein. That means the magnitude of the incoming velocity, which is v, remains the same, and therefore the outgoing velocity is also v in magnitude, but the direction changes. So v cos theta and minus v cos phi are the components of the velocities at the inlet and the outlet respectively, whereas v sin theta and v sin phi are the components of the velocities along the y direction at the inlet and the outlet respectively. Now, when you apply impulse momentum principle, impact of the jet is given by, we have seen it earlier, that it is equal to mass flow rate into change in velocity, and we can extend it to x or y or direction. So let us first consider the x direction. The x direction is marked here. So along the x direction, impact of the jet is given by fx is equal to mass flow rate. We have seen in all the earlier cases that the mass flow rate, the rate at which mass is flowing, is equal to mass density multiplied by discharge, that is mass density into area of the jet into velocity of the jet. Next, we have to consider change in velocity along the x direction. So what is the x component of velocity at the inlet, and what is the x component of velocity at the outlet? So x component of velocity at the inlet is v cos theta. So you have taken v cos theta here, minus x component of velocity at the outlet. It is v cos phi, and it is along the negative x direction. So we take it as minus v cos phi. So this can be rewritten as rho a into, take this common v outside. So rho a v square into cos theta plus cos phi, that is the impact of jet along the x direction, where theta is the vein angle at the inlet and phi is the vein angle at the outlet. In a similar way, we can calculate the impact of jet along the y direction as well. So along the y direction, impact of jet is equal to mass flow rate multiplied by the change in velocity along the y direction. Again, the mass striking remains the same, that is rho av, multiplied by change in velocity along the y direction. You have to see what is the velocity at the inlet along the y direction, what is the component of velocity at the outlet along the y direction. So change in velocity along the y direction is given by the inlet component, that is v sin theta, minus the component at the outlet, that is v sin phi. So mass flow rate rho av multiplied by v sin theta minus v sin phi. Taking the common v outside, the expression for fy becomes rho av square into sin theta minus sin phi. Thus, for a smooth, frictionless curved vein that is held stationary and is unsymmetrical about the x-axis, if the jet enters the vein tangentially, then the impact of jet to rho av square into sin theta minus sin phi, where rho is the mass density of the fluid of the jet, a is the cross-sectional area of the jet, v is the velocity of the jet, theta is the vein angle at the inlet, and phi is the vein angle at the outlet. If the vein is symmetrical about the x-axis, fx becomes rho AV square into 2 cos theta and Fi becomes 0. So if the vein is symmetrical, the force along the y direction get cancelled and it becomes 0. In this case, since the vein is stationary, work done by the jet on the vein is equal to 0. Now let us extend this to the case of a moving curved vein. An unsymmetrical, smooth and frictionless curved vein, and the jet enters the vein tangentially at one end, and under the impact of the jet, the vein moves with the velocity u along the x direction. In this case also, the jet gets deflected through an angle 180 minus theta plus phi, as we have seen earlier. Earlier we have seen in the case of a central jet, that is when the jet impinges on the vein at its center, we have seen impact of the jet is given by mass flow rate into change in velocity, where mass flow rate was taken as rho a into the relative velocity with which the jet was striking the vein, and for change in velocity we have considered the change in relative velocity in the respective direction. If you are talking about x direction, change in relative velocity along the x direction, or if you are talking about the y direction, change in relative velocity along the y direction. But in this case, u and v were in the same direction, that is velocity of the jet and the velocity of the vein were in the same direction, and we have determined the relative velocity like it is equal to v minus u, that is v is in the horizontal x direction, u is along the horizontal direction. So if you draw them together from the tip of u to the tip of v is the relative velocity, which becomes v minus u. All these are straight lines in the same direction, but the graphical representation shows that the velocity vector, relative velocity vector, is from the tip of u to the tip of v, and its magnitude is v minus u. But this case is different. Here the velocity of the jet is in this direction and velocity of the vein is in the horizontal x direction. When u and v are not in the same direction, how do we find the relative velocity? We represent relative velocity as v subscript r. So in this case, v r we take as the relative velocity of the inlet, and the same at the outlet is represented with a subscript 1, that is v r 1 represent the relative velocity of the outlet. In some of the textbook you can see that v r 1 is the relative velocity of the inlet. In such cases, Vr2 is taken as the relative velocity of the outlet. But in this lecture, I will be following this representation, that is Vr is the relative velocity of the inlet, whereas Vr1 is the relative velocity of the outlet. And if you have a smooth and frictionless vein, we assume that the relative velocity remains the same, that is relative velocity at the inlet is equal to the relative velocity of the outlet. And if he says that the jet enters the vein smoothly without any whirl or shock at the inlet, it means that the relative velocity is tangential to the vein at the inlet. In a similar way, if it says that the jet leaves the vein smoothly without any whirl or shock at the outlet, it means that the relative velocity at the outlet Vr1 is tangential to the vein at the outlet. What we are going to discuss now is how to find this relative velocity. In case of the central jet, when u and v were in the same direction, Vr was calculated as v minus u, that is from the tip of u to the tip of v gives you the relative velocity Vr, which is v minus u. But in this case, u and v are not in the same direction, therefore Vr is not equal to v minus u. Vr is not equal to v minus u. To calculate the relative velocity and hence the impact of jet in this case, we need to understand the velocity triangle in detail. That's what I am going to explain in detail now. Consider the case of an unsymmetrical curved vein, where vein angle at the inlet is theta and vein angle at the outlet is phi. A jet enters the vein tangentially and glides through the vein and leaves the vein in this direction. Under this impact, the vein moves with a velocity u along the horizontal x direction. So to draw the velocity triangle, first let us draw the absolute velocity of the jet at the inlet. So this is the absolute velocity of the jet at the inlet, and it is represented as v. If this is the direction of velocity of the jet, this is the direction of velocity of the vein. So let us draw the velocity vector of u at the inlet. So velocity of the jet and velocity of the vein are arranged from with their tails together. Now we can draw the third side of this triangle, that is the relative velocity at the inlet. So you can construct a triangle with velocity of the jet v and velocity of the vein u as the two sides of a triangle, such that the third side gives you the relative velocity at the inlet. This triangle is the inlet velocity triangle. Also, if you know the vector addition, you can also see the principle of vector addition here. Say first vector is velocity of the vein u, the second vector is the relative velocity, and these two vectors are arranged from their tail to tip. The first vector from its tail to tip, second vector from its tail to tip. Now resultant of u and vr can be obtained, resultant of these two vectors can be obtained if you draw a line from the tail of the first vector to the tip of the second vector, which in this case is v. So I can say that v is the resultant of u and vr, and vr is the relative velocity because of v and u. Vr is the relative velocity, or the other way of looking at this triangle is v is the resultant of u and vr. This gives you the inlet velocity triangle, a triangle formed with v and u as its sides, such that the closing side gives you the relative velocity at the inlet. So v is the jet velocity at the inlet, u is the vein velocity at the inlet, vr is the relative velocity of the jet at the inlet. If there is a friction between the jet and the vein, the relative velocity with which the jet is entering the vein need not be the same as the relative velocity with which the jet is leaving. So assume that there is some frictional loss taking place, and the relative velocity with which the jet is leaving the vein is taken as vr1. So vr1 is the relative velocity at the outlet. Now let us draw the velocity vector of the vein. So u1 is the velocity of the vein at the outlet. All the subscript 1 stands for the outlet. So you have two sides of a triangle, and the vectors are arranged from their tail to tip. Now you can draw the closing side, which will give you the resultant of vr1 and u1. Let me repeat, there are two vectors vr1 and u1, and they are arranged from their tail to tip. Vr1 is from tail to tip, u1 is from tail to tip. Now you can draw the closing side in such a way that it's a vector from the tail of the first vector to the tip of the second vector. That will give you the resultant of vr1 and u1. In this case, that is the absolute velocity of the jet at the outlet. This triangle is the velocity triangle at the outlet. So velocity triangle at the outlet is a triangle formed by vr1 and u1, such that the third side gives you the absolute velocity of the jet at the outlet. V1 is the absolute velocity of the jet at the outlet, u1 is the vein velocity at the outlet, and vr1 is the relative velocity of the jet at the outlet. In this case, you can see that vr1 is the result, v1 is the resultant of vr1 and u1. At the outlet, absolute velocity of the jet v1 is the resultant of vr1 and u1. At the inlet, absolute velocity of the jet v is the resultant of u and vr. So the velocity triangles are the triangles formed, maybe at the inlet you can define it as the triangle formed with u and v as its sides, such that the closing side gives you the relative velocity at the inlet. At the outlet, you start drawing the velocity triangle with VR1 followed by U1 such that the closing side gives you the absolute velocity of the jet at the outlet, that is V1. Now, in this case, if you say that there is no shock at the inlet and the outlet, it means that the jet enters the vane tangentially and it leaves the vane tangentially. So, the jet enters the vane tangentially means the relative velocity at the inlet is tangential to the vane. That is an important point to be kept in mind, not the absolute velocity. Relative velocity of the jet is tangential to the vane, that is Vr is tangential to the vane. Vane angle at the inlet is theta, therefore Vr makes an angle theta with the direction of u. So, theta is known as vane angle at the inlet and Vr makes an angle theta with the positive x direction. Similarly, at the outlet, when the jet leaves the vane tangentially, Vr1 is tangential to the vane at the outlet. Vane angle at the outlet is phi, therefore, for Vr1 to be tangential to the vane, Vr1 should be making an angle phi with a u1. So, vane angle outlet is phi and the angle between Vr1 and u1 is phi in this case. So, theta is the vane angle at the inlet, which is the angle that Vr makes with the x direction, and phi is the vane angle at the outlet, which is the angle that Vr1 makes with the x direction. Let us now consider the direction of the absolute velocities. What is the angle that V makes with u? What is the angle that V1 makes with u1? So, these are known as jet angles. So, alpha is the jet angle at the inlet, that is angle that absolute velocity of the jet makes with the direction of motion of the vane at the inlet. Absolute velocity of the jet at the inlet is V and velocity of the vane at the inlet is u. So, angle between V and u is alpha, which is the jet angle at inlet. So, this angle is alpha, that is the jet angle at the inlet. Similarly, angle that absolute velocity of the jet makes with the direction of motion of the vane at the outlet. Absolute velocity at the outlet is V1 and movement of the vane at the outlet is in this direction, that is along U1. Angle between U1 and V1 is the jet angle at outlet and is represented as beta. So, in this case, this is the angle beta. So, alpha is the jet angle at inlet, beta is the jet angle at the outlet. These triangles form at the inlet and the outlet of the vane are known as the velocity triangles. So, we have the inlet velocity triangle made by Vu and Vr. We have the outlet velocity triangle formed by Vr1, u1 and v1, where V and v1 are the velocities of the jet, V is at the inlet, v1 is at the outlet, u and u1 are the velocities of the vane, u at the inlet, u1 at the outlet, Vr and Vr1 are the relative velocities, Vr is at the inlet, Vr1 is at the outlet, theta is the vane angle at inlet, phi is the vane angle at the outlet, whereas alpha is the jet angle at the inlet and beta is the jet angle at the outlet. So, this triangle formed at the inlet is known as velocity triangle at the inlet or inlet velocity triangle. This triangle formed at the outlet is known as velocity triangle at the outlet or outlet velocity triangle. Inlet velocity triangle can be defined as the triangle formed by V and U such that the closing side is the relative velocity, or a triangle formed at the inlet in such a way that the absolute velocity of the jet V is the resultant of the velocity of the vane and the relative velocity at the inlet. Similarly, outlet velocity triangle is the triangle formed with Vr1 and u1 as its sides such that the third side gives you the absolute velocity at the outlet, or absolute velocity of the jet V1 is the resultant of relative velocity at the outlet Vr1 and the velocity of the vane u1 at the outlet. And if the vane is assumed to be smooth and frictionless, we can assume that the relative velocity of the inlet is Vr is equal to the relative velocity at the outlet Vr1. Let us take this a little further. We have this absolute velocity V. inclined at an angle theta to the direction of u. This absolute velocity can be resolved into components along u and perpendicular to that. If you do that, so here you can see the purple line, this is the component of v along the direction of u and this is perpendicular to that. The component of the absolute velocity of the jet along the direction of u is known as velocity of burn, which is represented as vw, v subscript w, and the perpendicular component is known as velocity of flow vf. So this is velocity of burn at the inlet, velocity of flow at the inlet. In a similar way, the absolute velocity at the outlet v1 can be resolved into component along u1 and perpendicular to that. So this is the perpendicular component and this is the component parallel to u1. These components are known as velocity of burn at the outlet, which is along the direction of u1, perpendicular to that is known as velocity of flow at the outlet. So vw subscript 1 stands for outlet, vf subscript 1 stands for outlet. So velocity of burn is the component of the absolute velocity. You need to be very careful here, it's a component of the absolute velocity of the jet. So component of v along the direction of motion of the vane along u is known as velocity of burn. Component of v perpendicular to the direction of motion of the vane is known as velocity of flow. Same is with the outlet. Component of v1 along u1 is known as velocity of whirl at the outlet. Component of v1 perpendicular to that is known as velocity of flow at the outlet. So vw is the velocity of whirl at the inlet, vw1 is the velocity of whirl at the outlet. Similarly, vf is the velocity of flow at the inlet, whereas vf1 is the velocity of flow at the outlet. That completes the velocity triangle at the inlet and outlet. So I can define the velocity triangle at the inlet as the triangle formed by the velocity vectors of the jet v and the vane u in such a way that the third side represents the relative velocity of the jet at the inlet, that is vr. Similarly, velocity triangle at the outlet can be defined as the relative velocities of the jet vr1 and the absolute velocity of the vane u1 are the sides of the triangle, such that the third side, that is v1, gives the absolute velocity of the jet at the outlet, that is the velocity triangle. Thus, to summarize our discussion, if you have an unsymmetrical curved vane and if the vane is stationary and if a jet is entering the vane tangentially, the impact of jet along the x and y directions are given by fx equal to rho ab square into cos theta plus cos phi, and fy is equal to rho ab square into sin theta minus sin phi, where theta and phi are the vane angles at the inlet and the outlet respectively. In case of a stationary vane, work done is equal to 0. If the vane is moving with a velocity u, and in this case we can see that u and v are not in the same direction, we need to consider the relative velocity with which the jet is striking the vane. And this relative velocity can be determined by drawing the velocity triangle. And velocity triangle is the triangle drawn in such a way that velocity of the jet v is the resultant of the vane velocity u and the relative velocity of the jet vr. And we have also discussed in detail how to draw the velocity triangle at the inlet and the outlet. We will continue this discussion in the next lecture. Thank you.